Hello.
Hi, teacher.
Hi, teacher.
I'm really sorry, pero acá está una tormenta horrible. Y no sé, un rayo como que había impactado o algo así. Y me fue la energía por un momento. Espero que podamos.
No voy a decir mentiras. No voy a decir mentiras.
Come on, it's not lying. I do really like it with you.
Vamos a sacar terminación nosotros por su.
Qué valor. Yo ya dije que me voy a portar bien y voy a estar callada.
Ahí estaban practicando durante su ausencia, teacher.
Ay, a ver, ya ve. Yo sabía que.
Ya pasamos el listado.
¿Es el listado? Ok, that's cool. Así me llega, por eso es que me encanta este grupo. Aunque ciertas personitas acá no me quieran ver acá. Ana María.
Ya ven, novia, que le dije. A ver, o sea, yo.
No. I'm just kidding. Okay. I'm glad to be here again. Okay. Espero pues ya no tengamos problemas de conexión. Let's continue. Bien, aparte de las daily activities, okay, también podemos utilizar el simple present, okay, with scheduled events, right? Okay, eventos ya preestablecidos, eventos que ya tenemos una hora indicada en la cual lo vamos a hacer. Es como cuando nosotros tenemos una agenda de lo que generalmente hacemos todos los días, okay? An example of it. She has a meeting at 1 p.m. You see, that's something that is on the list that we got every day, okay? She has a meeting at 1 p.m., okay? That's something that is really scheduled on a timetable. All right. Right after here, do we have any question? Hasta acá, ¿tenemos alguna pregunta, alguna duda? About what we're doing? That's nice. Okay, it seems everything is going perfectly. Okay, cool. If you have copied that, let's move on. Avancemos. Are you still copying that? ¿Todavía están copiando ahí? Just let me know so I can wait.
Finish.
Okay.
Finish, teacher.
All right, perfect. Thank you. Let's see. Natalie, I want you to do a favor to me. Dígale a su compañera de trabajo que ya iniciaron las clases, okay? Y si no tiene el link, y si en un dado caso no le ha caído el link, mándeselo el de las clases, ¿ok? No tengo el número de ella, pero coméntele ahí, porque la vez pasada dijo que había faltado una semana por que no le había caído la notificación.
Ajá, Urrutia.
Exacto.
Ajá, sí, ahora porque no la vi, pero imaginé que ya lo tenía. Pero, teacher, la otra muchacha, otra Stephanie, ella no se puede conectar. No sé si toda esta semana va a estar ausente, porque está mal de salud.
Really?
Ajá, entonces ahora estuvo así como ingresada, no sé si ya la habrán dado de alta. Ajá, entonces, de Stephanie Urrutia, sí, mañana la voy a ver, le voy a comentar. Ajá, pero de Stephanie Vázquez, sí, no sabría decir.
Okay, all right. Okay, thank you for telling me. Let's continue then. Okay, affirmative and negative statements. Acá vamos a hacer un pequeño repaso sobre las oraciones afirmativas y negativas, okay? Using first person. Using first person. Eric, help me out reading, please. Affirmative statements.
I play the guitar.
Okay, very good. I play the guitar. Carla, second sentence.
You go to the supermarket.
Okay, very good. You go to the supermarket. Remember, these are activities that we generally do, not probably every day, but it's continuously, okay? That's why we use simple present. Salvador. Read for me, please.
Okay, they work in the office.
Okay, very good. They work in an office. Let's see, Ana Garcia. Let's read, Ana.
We get up at 5 a.m.
Okay, very good. We get up at 5 a.m. Okay, perfect. That's great. Okay, so these examples are using first person, second person, and plurals. Remember, in that case, the verb doesn't have any change, okay? Now, the negative statements, okay? Ahora bien, con los negatives, ¿qué generalmente agregamos a una oración, okay, para transformarla en negativo? What do we use to make it from positive to negative?
Doesn't
in third person, but in first and plural?
Does not.
Exactly, all right? As auxiliary verb, we got do plus not, okay? And we join it and create one single word that in this case is don't.
Deja, mamá.
All right?
No te llenes toda, mira, ve.
Don't. Okay, good. So we got that example in here. So you see, let's see, Jonathan, help me reading the first example.
I don't play the guitar.
Okay, thank you. I don't play the guitar. So you see, we got I, which is the subject. Recordemos, el subject, el sujeto, que puede ser un pronombre o puede ser un nombre propio, okay? A proper noun, okay? So we got I, and then the auxiliary verb do plus not. That together or contracted is don't. And then the main verb, verbo principal. That case is play. And then the guitar is the complement. So I don't play the guitar. So we got that in negative. In the left side, we got I play the guitar. Positive. On the right, we got I don't play the guitar. That's something negative. Fatima, read the second example.
You don't go to the supermarket.
Okay. You don't go to the supermarket. Very good. So you see, after the subject, well, we got the auxiliary verb do. Plus not, and then the main verb. In this case is go. And then to the supermarket, that is the complement, okay? And then we got the next example for Joanny. Help me out.
They don't work in an office.
Okay, thank you. They don't work in an office, very good. And the last one, Rosa del Carmen.
We don't get up at 5 a.m.
Okay, we don't get up at 5 a.m. Okay, that's really cool. So remember, we got affirmative statements and we also have negative statements in this case. This is when we talk about first person and second person, and also plurals, okay? We have not touched third person. Okay, cool. Now, I want some examples from you using negative statements. Okay, now, I want you to think in one activity that you do not do every day, or you don't generally do. For example, okay, I don't cook my food. Okay, that's an example, okay? Example. It doesn't mean that I don't cook, all right? Eric, Ya me están apuntando con el dedo así como, ah, no, 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 no. It's an example. Okay, Eric, give me an example of something that you don't do.
I don't cook my breakfast.
Okay, all right. Good, man. An example, right? Just an example.
Really, really.
Okay, man. All right. Thank you. Okay. William, tell me an activity that you don't do.
I don't take in vacation.
I don't take my vacation.
Yes.
Okay, that's so sad, man. We don't have vacations. All right, William, thank you. Romeo. Hey, Romeo. Change the name, man. Okay, give me an example of something that you don't know.
El último ejemplo, por ejemplo.
Ah, no, Romeo, quiero que me dé un ejemplo de una actividad que usted no hace.
Ah, bueno. Sí, entonces, I don't watch TV. Sí, no creíble, pero sí.
Okay, I will say yes. I don't believe you, but I will say yes. Okay. Okay, Romeo, thank you. Carlos Eduardo. Tell me something you don't do, man.
I don't take exercise.
You don't do exercise?
No. I don't have very time.
Same here, man. Same here. Yeah. Un día me estoy bien animado y like, hey, hoy tengo que hacer ejercicio. Es cuando amanezco más dormido. But anyway, it happens. Yes. Okay, good. Natalie, tell me something you don't do.
Okay, I don't drink alcohol.
Alcohol.
Mm-hmm.
Good. Good. Right. I would say that's good. All right, thank you, Natalie. Roxana.
Okay.
Okay. Roxana, tell me something you don't do.
I don't eat moras.
I don't eat
moras.
Ah, okay. All right. Okay, thank you, Roxana. Nubia, tell me yours.
I don't watch TV on the week.
During the week?
During the week.
Okay, okay. All right. I will believe you. I will. Yeah, it's like, you're like me in that case, because I bought a TV and a smart TV, and I put a long list of channels through the internet, and I don't watch it during the whole week. I don't have time. I'm moving from one place to another place, and when I finish this work, I just go to sleep. That's it. So sad. Okay, Nubia, thank you. Okay. Ana Maria, something you don't do?
I don't eat lobster.
Ah, okay. Why not? That's delicious. Okay, Ana Maria. Carla, tell me something you don't do.
Okay. I don't play soccer.
Ah, can you please repeat your example?
I don't play soccer.
Ah, okay. All right. But you like soccer?
No, like.
No, okay. Okay. All right. You don't like soccer and you don't play soccer. Okay, cool. Okay, thank you, Carla. Because of time, let's move on, okay? For the rest that has not participated, we're gonna do it at the end. Let's see. Now, let's switch into per person, affirmative, negative statements using per person. Remember, in per person, it's when we talk about he, she, it, and proper names, okay? Like in this case, I can mention Carla, Ana, Salvador, okay? One single person. Examples. Janet, read the first example.
Okay. She sent text messages.
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 Okay, very good. Thank you. All right. In this case, remember, in this case, the verb suffers the change. Okay. Now it's not only send. We have to add the S to the verb because it's third person. Okay. She sends text messages. Okay. We have to write the S to the verb send. Let's see who can help me out. Joanny.
He cooks pasta.
Okay. He cooks pasta. So you see, in that case, the verb cook, we got the S. We add the S because we're talking about third person. Let's see the next. Amilcar.
Mario goes to Guatemala.
Okay. Mario goes to Guatemala. All right. Thank you, mister. So in that case, acá ya no tenemos un pronoun, okay? In here, we got a proper noun, okay? So, and it remains the same. So you see, Mario goes to Guatemala, okay? Do you still remember the uses of this type of rules? Do you remember the rule? When do we add ES to the verb?
And la boca. La O.
Okay. When the verb finishes in O, double S, what else? SH,
yes.
PH, X, right? Cuando tiene esas terminaciones, yes. Cuando tiene esas terminaciones, ok, cuando tiene esas terminaciones, agregamos ES al verbo. Recordamos, right? Cuando un verbo termina en doble S, SH, CH, X, en O. ¿Ok? Y O. Entonces, ¿qué hacemos en tercera persona? We add ES. Agregamos ES al verbo. En este caso, el verbo go, we add ES. So that's why we got goes. ¿Ok? All right, cool. Let's see. Hilmar, help me out reading.
Karina fixes her cell phone.
All right, Karina fixes her cell phone. There you go. So we got the verb fix, okay? Ends in X. The verb ends in X. What do we do in this case? We add ES, okay? In third person. Remember that this happens only in third person affirmative statements. Okay. Now, negative statements. With the past slide, we used to write down do to the negative statements. But now, since it is third person, remember, now it's not going to be do. It's going to be das. Okay, very good. It's going to be das. And the main verb remains the same. We don't add the S. Example. Let's see. Ana Garcia, read this example, please.
She don't.
Doesn't.
Send, she doesn't. Sends.
Text messages.
No puedo ver completa la oración, no me permite. Ahorita.
Okay, okay.
Ahorita. She doesn't send text messengers.
Messages, okay.
Messages.
Okay, thank you. All right, she doesn't send text messages. If you see the main verb in that case, send, it doesn't have the S. Why? Because the auxiliary verb do is now transformed into does. That's why we don't use the S to the verb, to the main verb. En este caso, el verbo principal ya no le agregamos S. Okay? ¿Por qué? Porque el auxiliar toma la acción de la tercera persona. El auxiliar, el verbo auxiliar es el que está haciendo la modificación. Okay? Let's put that into context. Okay, let's see who else can help me out. Carla, read, please.
Okay. He does cook pasta.
All right. He doesn't cook pasta. Okay, same thing, right? Same thing. All right, and let's see. Salvador?
Negativa.
Yeah.
Sure. My question?
No, in that case, read for me the last example that we got in there, in negative.
Okay. Mario
doesn't
go to Guatemala.
Okay. All right. Thank you. Mario doesn't go to Guatemala. Okay. Cool. And we got the last one. Eric. Let's finish.
Karina doesn't fix her cell phone.
All right. Karina doesn't fix her cell phone. Okay. Let's remember, these are just negatives. Okay. Using third person. Using third person. Do you have any question related to this? Something that might not be clear for you? Or everything is okay? Everything is fine? Okay. Perfect. I don't know if you're copying that. No sé si todavía lo están copiando. Just let me know.
Finish.
Finish.
All right. Perfect. Okay, cool. Perfect. Listen up. It is 9:04. I'm going to stop a little bit. I'm going to pass the attendance list and then we continue. Give me a second, please. Oh my God. Okay. Amilcar Gustavo.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. Ana Claribel.
Present.
Excellent. Ana Maria.
Present.
Okay. Carlos Eduardo.
Present.
Okay, perfect. Thank you. Eric Guillermo.
Present.
All right, thank you. Stephanie Janet.
Not here.
Present.
Not here.
Fatima Alejandra.
Present, teacher.
Okay, thank you. Hilmar Cruz.
Present.
Okay, thank you. Jonathan Alexander.
Present.
Okay, excellent. Carla Benazir.
Present.
Okay, thank you. Natalie Vanessa.
Present.
Okay. Nubia Zulema.
Present.
Thank you. Romeo Alexis.
Present.
Okay, thank you. Rosa del Carmen.
Present.
Okay, cool. Roxana Yesenia.
Present, teacher.
Okay, thank you. Salvador Alfonso.
Present, teacher.
Okay, thank you. Stephanie Adeline. Okay. She's sick. Stephanie Lisette. Okay, she's not here too. William Alberto.
Present.
Okay, thank you. And Joanny Noemi.
Present.
Okay, cool. Let's continue with the presentation. We got something to do later after this. Okay, and right after this, what have we got? We're gonna have a short conversation to practice, okay? And we are going to do the same dynamic as we have done before. Listen up. Voy a leer una vez la conversación completa, okay, para que nos vayamos, digamos, like trying to adequate the vocabulary. En este caso, tal vez vocabulario que todavía no conozcamos de la conversación. Cuando termine de practicar la conversación o leerla, si hay alguna palabra que no comprendamos, por favor me lo hacen saber, ¿ok? Porque luego esta conversación la vamos a practicar en parejas. I do really want you to practice this conversation. Ok, give me a second. So this conversation is between Sofía and Mario. And it says, listen up. Ahí con los micrófonos apagados podemos seguir la lectura, ¿ok? There's no problem. Voy a dar siempre un espacio para que podamos ir practicando poco a poco, like from there. It says, Sofía, what do you do every Monday morning? What do you do every Monday morning? Right? And it says, Mario, I check my email. I check my email and I call clients and I call clients for the rest of the morning. For the rest of the morning. What about you? What about you? Okay. And it says, Sofía, I have to read a weekly report. I have to read a weekly report and attend a meeting. And attend a meeting. I also have to organize meetings. To organize meetings every 2 Mondays. Every 2 Mondays. How often do you check your email? How often do you check your email? Do you check it every day? Do you check it every day? And it says, Mario, yes, I do, actually. Yes, I do, actually. I check it once or twice a day. I check it once or twice a day. And it says, Sofía, great. It is very important. Great. It is very important. Okay, from here, from this conversation, ¿hay alguna palabra de esta conversación que no comprendamos del todo? Just let me know, okay? And we can solve it before going to the practice.
Teacher. Teacher.
Yeah, tell me.
En Sofía, en la tercera, I have to read a esa palabra.
Weekly. Okay, weekly.
Weekly.
Yeah, weekly means, okay. Weekly. Yeah, weekly significa semanalmente. Okay, en este caso, en conjunto con la palabra report, significa reporte semanal. Okay, weekly report, like reporte semanal. All right, any other word that probably we got problems with?
How often?
How often? Okay. How often means
¿Qué tan frecuente o qué tan a menudo? Okay, that's what it means. ¿Qué tan frecuente usted hace una actividad? Example. Si yo le pregunto, how often do you take a shower? ¿Cómo será su respuesta? I always take a shower, in my case. In your case, it would be, I take a shower once a week. Para ahorrar agua. No, I'm kidding. I'm just kidding. All right. No, in that case, how often es para mencionar, o sea, para preguntar qué tan a menudo nosotros hacemos una actividad. Okay? That's the meaning. Okay, cool. Any other word? What is attend?
Teacher. Uh-huh. What is the pronunciation? I call clients. Clients.
Clients.
Clients. Okay.
Yeah. Clients. Okay. The word attend. In this case, the verb attend. What is attend? Do we know what is that? Attend. Like in this case, attend meetings. Carlos Eduardo, what is attend?
Hello.
What is attend?
Hola.
Hola, Carlos. ¿Me escucha?
Hola, teacher.
Okay. Do you listen to me?
Yes.
Okay. For you, what is the verb attend? The one that appears in the conversation. ¿Qué significa?
What is attend?
Mm-hmm.
Where?
There is a part where it says attend meetings.
Como ¿qué tan a menudo me reúno? Algo así, ¿verdad? ¿O tengo reuniones?
No, en this case, solo le estoy preguntando si conoce el verbo que está ahí en la conversación, que dice attend a meeting. Attend.
Sí, sí.
Ok, what does it mean?
Reunirse, reunión.
All right. But the verb attend, all right, for everybody. The word attend means asistir. Okay? That's what it is. Es una manera formal de poder decir de asistir, o sea, a un evento o a una reunión, okay? That is attend. Okay, very good. Okay, what are we going to do with this conversation? Listen up. Ya que todos tenemos los manuales, okay? This conversation is from the manual. Okay? This conversation is from the manual. And you can do it from here or you can do it from the manual, okay? But like right now, we're gonna start with a short practice. I'm gonna give you 10 minutes for you to practice this conversation. Les voy a dar, let's see, 9:15. 9:25, okay? Voy a cortar la práctica and then we're gonna move on to here, okay? Pero quiero que practiquemos esta conversación in small pairs. Vamos a compartir las salas, okay, los breakout rooms, y quiero que me practiquen esta conversación en pareja. Okay, I will do it for about 9 minutes. Okay, let's practice that conversation in pairs. Okay, uno puede tomar la acción de Mario, otro Sofía, y luego like do it the other way around. Okay, if you have the manuals, I think we are not going to have any problem. Bien, voy a dejar de compartir pantalla un momento and then to create the breakout rooms. Give me a second. Let's see. Oh, that's cool. Tenemos 18. It's going to be great. Vamos a estar en pareja. Okay, let's see. All right, perfect. Bien, solo para confirmar, todos tenemos el manual, ¿cierto?
Todos tenemos. No, teacher. Ese es el nuevo, teacher. ¿Verdad?
Ya, yeah, the new one.
No, no lo tengo hasta ahora que usted lo mandó.
¿No lo ha descargado de WhatsApp, Joanny?
No, es que no me había caído hasta ahorita que usted lo volvió a mandar, me cayó. No sé si...
Ok, ok, pero ¿ya lo descargó, Joanny?
Sí, ya.
Ah, ok, perfecto. All right, perfect. From that, de ese manual, nos vamos a ir para la página, let's see, 9, página 9, ok? And there you will find that conversation. Ahí vamos a encontrar la conversación, ok? This one. Let's practice it hasta las 9:25, la vamos a practicar, ok? It's for you to get along with this type of conversations. Ok, bien, démosle aceptar ahí, por favor. Go there. And let's practice. Romeo, are you there? Perfect.
Se me quita, espéreme.
Ah, de verdad.
Sí, espéreme.
Hey, ahora sí. What happening here?
Muy, muy temprano, teacher. Nos íbamos a saludar con Fátima. A saludarnos, vamos.
Come on, I mean, estaban bla, 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 bla. Nomás entro.
No.
A complete silence.
No, lo que pasa es que no podía quitar el mute.
Ah, ok.
Ajá, no tenía micrófono.
Ok, yo creí que decía, pero... cállese que viene el teacher.
Cállese
no,
que viene el teacher. All right. No, ahorita vamos a empezar ya la práctica.
Ok, perfecto.
Ahorita ahí vamos a empezar.
Ok, let's do it. Voy a revisar otros grupos entonces. Exactamente 9:25, let's go back, ok?
Yeah. Ok.
Very good.
Gracias, teacher.
Tomorrow. How often do you check your email? Do you check it every day?
Yes, I do actually. I check it once or twice a day.
Great. This is very important.
Candela, si quieres, de nuevo. What do you do every Monday morning?
I check my email for client for the rest of the morning. What about you?
I have to read a weekly report and attend a meeting. I also have to organize meeting every two Monday. How often do you check your email? Do you check it every day?
Yes, I do a project. I check it once or twice a day.
Great, it's very important.
What do you do every Monday morning?
I check my email, call client for
Empezamos.
Sí.
Sí. Ok. Empiezo.
Sí.
Ok. What do you do every Monday morning?
I check my email and I call clients for the rest of the morning. What about you?
I have to read a weekly report and attend a meeting. I also have to organize
organize Organize.
Organize, se me había olvidado.
Okay.
Organize means every 2 Mondays. How often do you check your email? Do you check it every day?
Yes, I do actually. I check it once or twice a day.
Great. It is very important. Ahora usted, Sofía.
What do you do every day, Monday morning?
Every. I shake my email and I call clients for you for the rest of the morning.
You.
Bye. Tú eres Sofía, siempre.
Okay. I have to read a weekly report and attend a meeting. I also have to the organized meeting every 2 Mondays. How often do you check your email? Do you check it every day?
Yes, I do, actually. I check it once or twice a day.
Great, it's very important.
Okay, so Sofia, what do you do every Monday morning?
I check my email and I call client.
Yes, con Sofía.
Voy a empezar yo nuevamente. What do you do every Monday morning?
I check my email and I'll call clients for the rest of the morning. What about you?
I have to read a weekly report. I attend a meeting. I also have to organize
un muchacho que se llama. Hi, teacher.
Hi.
Hi.
How many times have you practiced?
Ahorita. Yo empiezo hoy.
Espérame,
voy a meter en la otra página. Ajá. ¿Me escucho?
Ya.
¿Sí? Ya.
But what do you do every Monday morning?
I check my email and I call clients for the rest of the morning. What about you?
I have to read a weekly report and attend a meeting. I also have to organize meeting every 2 Mondays. How often do you check your email? Do you check it every day?
Yes, I do actually. I check it once or twice a day.
Great. It is very important.
Nice. Now let's go that to the main room, okay? Vámonos a la sala principal ya. It's okay, 9:26. And let's see the practice.
Okay.
All right. Let's see.
¿Qué me estaba diciendo, Nubia?
Que si no es familiar con Jonathan Claro.
No sé quién es.
¿Qué más?
All right, so we're coming back from the main rooms, and let's see what you have practiced. Okay, let's see. Carla, I'm gonna start with you. You're the first on the list from here. I got here. Carla, who do you practice with? The microphone off. Turn it on, please.
Se me olvidó el nombre del muchacho.
Ay, come on, Carla. Are you serious? Ah, let's see.
Es que no tenía encendida la cámara y no le vi el nombre.
Okay, all right, let's see.
I have.
Isn't it William?
Yes.
Carla, he used to be your classmate in module number 2. I mean, wow. Number 1. You don't remember? Okay. But anyways, I'm going to share the presentation thing, okay, for you to practice the better, all right? Okay, Carla. And William, let's start. I want to listen to you.
Comienzo yo.
Yes.
All right, do it.
Okay. What do you do every Monday morning?
I check my email and I call clients for the rest of the morning. What about you?
I have to read a weekly report and arrange a meeting. I also have to organize meetings every 2 Mondays. How often do you check your emails? Do you check it every day?
Yes, I do actually. I check it once or twice a day.
Great. It's very important.
It is very important. All right. Thank you, Carla, and thank you, William. You did it excellent. Okay. Now, Carlos Eduardo, who did you work with?
Gilmar.
All right, cool. Let's practice.
Gilmar.
Hola. Bueno, comienzo yo con Sofía. All
right.
What do you do every Monday morning?
I check my email and I call clients for the rest of the morning. What about you?
I have to read a weekly report and attend a meeting. I also have to organize meetings every 2 Mondays. How often do you check your emails? Do you check it every day?
Yes, I do actually. I check it once or twice a day.
Great. It is very important.
Okay.
Okay, very good. Thank you, Hilmer, and thank you, Carlos. Okay, let's remember that's once. What is once? Significa una vez, right? Once, just the word. And twice means dos veces, okay? Very good. Let's see who's next. Natalie, who do you work with?
Salvador.
Okay, good. Let's start.
Okay, Salvador, empiezo yo. What do you do every Monday morning?
I check my email. I'll check client for the rest of the morning. But about you?
I have to read a weekly report and attend a meeting. I also have to organize meetings every 2 Mondays. How often do you check your email? Do you check it every day?
Yes, I do actually. I check it once or twice a day.
Great. It is very important.
Okay, very good. Okay, great. It is very important. Thank you, Natalie, and thank you, Salvador. Right, you did it good. Fatima, who do you work with?
Ana Maria.
Okay. Let's do it.
Ana María.
Hola, hola, aquí estoy.
Inicio yo.
Sí, sí.
What do you do every Monday morning?
I check my email and I call clients for the rest of the morning. What about you?
I have to read a weekly report and attend a meeting. I also have to organize a meeting every 2 Mondays. How often do you check your email? Do you check it every day?
Yes, I do. Actually, I check it once or twice a day.
Great. It is very important.
Okay, very good. All right, nice. So thank you to you both. Now, Ana Garcia, who did you practice with?
Con Eric.
Okay, let's do it.
Okay. No sé si comienzo yo, Eric.
Sí, sir. Sí, por favor.
What do you do every Monday morning?
I check my email and I call clients for the rest of the morning. What about you?
I have to read a weekly report and attend a meeting. I also have to organize meeting every 2 Mondays. How often do you check your email? Do you check it every day?
Yes, I do actually. I check it once or twice a day.
Great, it is very important.
Okay, perfect.
Thank you.
Thank you to you both. Now, okay. Let's see who's next. Janet.
Sí.
All right.
Con Rosa, creo.
You think? Okay.
Yes.
All right, let's do it.
¿Empiezo yo, Rosa?
Sí.
Bye. What do you do every Monday morning?
I check my email and I call clients for the rest of the morning. What about you?
I have to read a weekly report and attend a meeting. I also have to organize meetings every 2 Mondays. How often do you check your email? Do you check it every day?
Yes, I do check it once or twice a day.
Okay.
Great. It is very important.
Okay, very good. I told the sign I was liking. All right. Thank you, Rosa, and thank you, Stephanie. You did it excellent. Let's see who's next. No. Did you practice, Fatima?
Yes, teacher.
Yeah, okay, thank you. Let's see, Nubia.
Hi, teacher.
All right, Nubia.
I practiced with Joanny Claros.
Ah, okay, let's do it.
Okay. What do you do every Monday morning?
I check my email. And I call clients for the rest of the morning. What about you?
I have to read a weekly report and attend a meeting. I also have to organize meetings every 2 Mondays. How often do you check your email? Do you check it every day?
Yes, I do actually. Check it once or twice a day.
Great, it is very important.
Okay, very good, Novia. And thank you to the person who you were practicing with. All right, yeah, in this case, it was Joanne, right? Cool, Roxana, who do you practice with?
con Romeo, teacher.
Okay, with Romeo. Okay, Romeo. And Roxana, let's do it.
Que inicie Romeo.
Okay, Romeo.
Voy a iniciar eso. Yo, Romeo.
Ah, ya, vaya, saben.
Okay.
Iniciaría yo. What do you do every Monday morning?
I check my email and I call
clients
for the stretch of the morning. What about you?
I have to be
weekly
report and after a meal I have to organize meeting every Monday. How often do you check your mail? Check it every day.
Yes, I do. I check once or twice a day.
Okay, Roxana, thank you, and thank you, Romeo. Great, it is very important. All right, who's missing? Amilcar, I think you're missing.
I'm going to go with Jonathan. No.
Okay, man, do it.
Jonathan, si quieres, empiezo yo.
Hey, where's Jonathan? I think Jonathan is not here, man. Let's see. Nope, not here. Okay, Fatima, help me out with Amilcar, please.
Okay. Inicio yo?
Yo soy yo, si usted. What do you do every Monday morning?
I check my emails and I call clients for the rest of the morning. What about you?
I have to read a weekly report and attend a meeting. I also have to organize meetings every two Monday. How often do you check your email? Do you check it every day?
Yes, I do actually. I check it once or twice a day.
Great. It's a very important.
Okay, thank you, Fatima, for helping out with Amilcar. All right, you both did it good. Okay, now let's finish this short practice that we had. And now what are we gonna do? Listen up. We're gonna move on to the manuals and let's start working in some exercises that we have to do over there, okay? That's what we are going to do like right now, okay? Let's work in the manuals. Just give me a second. I'm going to put the manuals in here just to share the screen and let's work on them. Give me a second, please. Let's see. Okay, we got it in here. I didn't take it from the platform. I got the PDF in here. Okay. All right. First thing that we're gonna be doing, like right now, this is the conversation that we have been practicing, okay, between Sofia and Mario. Now, putting this apart, I want, listen up, I want you to read the conversation again, okay, this conversation again, and answer these questions. Question number one, it says, what activities do Mario and Sofia do on Mondays? Quiero que me escriban acá, okay? Como lo tenemos en PDF por el momento, quiero que en sus cuadernos, like there, me escriban las actividades que Mario y Sofía mencionan que hacen los lunes. Okay? Let's do that. And then I'm going to ask you for that. And then number two, it says, do you consider that it's important to check your email every day? Esa sí va a ser individual y se los voy a preguntar a cada uno de ustedes. Okay? That's personal. Vamos a colocar ahí. Okay? You can look, you can do like that. Me van a colocar ahí porque consideran ustedes que es importante hacerlo. Porque es importante revisar nuestro correo todos los días. Okay? And a small answer. That's it. Nothing too complicated, please. Let me know when you finish. Just let me know when you finish and we can move on. All right. All right, just to note the activities, I'm going to put the conversation in here so you can read it. Okay, just a model of example. Si dice, what activities do Mario and Sofia do every Monday? Recordemos, no vamos a poner I check my email. Pueden poner Mario, dos puntos. He checks his email, all right? And call clients. Like something like that. Vamos a omitir el I.
Teacher.
Yes.
Puede ser también Mario checks.
Yeah.
Sería his.
Yeah, his, remember.
His email.
Exactly, his.
Okay.
Yeah, Mario checks his email and then the rest. All right, just let me know when you finish. All right, you finish?
Finish.
Okay, excellent. Okay, let's wait for the rest. Let's see. The activities that Mario does. This is one, and this is another one, right? How about Sophia? Sophia has this activity, and this other, and this. What do you say, Jonathan? Poco lo escucho, Jonathan, no lo entiendo muy bien. I don't know if you're having problems, Jonathan, with the internet. All right, I think you have problems with the internet. Okay, let's start up. Janet, since you were the first one to finish, tell me, what activities do Mario and Sofia do on Mondays?
Yo puse eso, teacher, no sé. They have to organize meetings every 2 Mondays.
Okay. Okay, that's one of them. All right. Okay, esa es una de las maneras que la podemos usar. En este caso, Stephanie, it says, let's see, how many. Pero como dice, on Mondays, podemos incluir. They check email, call clients, read a weekly report, and attend meetings. Okay, and also organize meetings. Si lo hemos hecho de manera individual, okay, acá les quedaría. What activities do Mario and Sofia do on Monday? Example, Mario. What does Mario do? In that case, Mario, it says, Mario checks his email and call clients, right? Those are the 2 activities that Mario does. In the case of Sofia, Sofia, it says, she has to read a weekly report. Okay. She has, ya no sería have, sería has, remember? She has to read a weekly report and attend meetings. Okay. And attends meetings. Also, vamos a poner also, acá la palabra que tengo marcada, also. Podemos poner, she has, no have, la tercera persona de have, recordemos. Also, she has to, okay, give me a second, what did I do? Oh my God, I move on. No. Quantum and free. Okay, good. And here. Also, she has to organize meetings. Right? That's it. That's it. Okay? Also, she has to organize meetings. Okay? Those are the activities that they do. Okay. Now, this is taken from here. Now, the next question, this is personal for you. Okay, and I'm gonna ask this question to give me a second. I'm gonna choose one. Carlos Eduardo, Do you consider that it is important to check your email every day?
Yes.
Why?
It's very important to be updated with the information of the company. Also, better performance in your day.
Okay, very good. Okay, very good. Very good explanation, mister. Thank you. Okay. Let's see. Who else can help me out? Joanny, tell me your answer.
Yes. And you actually...
Okay, and why? Why, Joanny? Why?
Okay. Ay, que no sabía qué más ponerle.
In that case, it was like, ¿qué pensaba usted? ¿Por qué es importante revisar nuestro correo todos los días?
Por las actualizaciones.
All right.
Y este... por la organización que ellos llevan.
Ah, okay.
Por los clientes.
Nah, okay. Nice. Thank you. Let's see. Hilmar, what do you think?
It is the easiest way to share information and be in contact not only within the same company, but also with your clients.
Ah, okay, perfect. That's a good explanation. Okay, good reason. Thank you, Mr. Now Salvador. All right, Mr. You can see that it's important to check your email every day, and why?
For the change, the company daily.
Nah.
For example, press change.
Okay. All right. Yeah, that's a good reason to be updated every day, right? And check the email. All right, cool. So everybody got the same reasons. Some of them have different reasons, but it's really important for us, especially when we work. It is really important for us to check our emails like almost every day, okay? And that's something that we have to do. Okay, let's move on. Listen up. In here, listen up. This is something related to the activities that we do every day, okay? As part of our daily routine. Okay, and since we have been practicing simple present, this is a common activity that a person does in the workplace, okay? And it says, on Mondays, check my email, type a letter, write a report, attend a meeting. Number five, call clients. Number six, read a report. Number seven, visit clients. Number eight, organize meetings. Okay, we got missing. It is missing number nine and number 10. What are we going to do? Listen up. In your notebooks, I want you to write two activities to complete that schedule activities, okay? Quiero que ahí me añadan dos actividades que crean ustedes que pueden continuar con el desarrollo de esa agenda, ¿ok? On Mondays. Taking it personal. Supongamos que esa sea su agenda para el día lunes. ¿Cuáles serían esas otras dos actividades que ustedes pueden añadirle? Let's do it. And let me know later. I think we're going to finish with that because tomorrow we're going to be working with this. Yeah, by tomorrow. just two sentences, all right? I mean, just two activities. It's pretty easy.
The second, probably organize meeting.
Organize meetings, okay. And the next, and the last one?
Check my email.
Check the email. Let's see. Isn't it here? Let me see. That's number one in here.
Number check my email. And number three.
Okay. Those are like the ones that you should add. All right. Okay. But in this case, we're adding two extra. Okay, activities besides those ones. Okay, what else would you do if that agenda could be yours? ¿Qué otras actividades? En este caso, dos actividades podría añadir aparte de todas las que tenemos ahí para completar 10 actividades.
Y for me.
All right, Ana María, tell me.
Take a class the English.
Take an English class? Ah, nice. With a co-teacher, right?
Me teacher.
All right, Hilmar?
Assign tasks.
Assign, en ese caso, assign tasks.
Tasks.
Ah, okay, very good. Assign tasks. Okay, very good. Somebody else? Let's see.
Sell its products.
Ah, okay, very good, William. That's another one, very good.
Feedback employed, podría ser.
Ah, okay. Feedback to employees. Very good. Give me only one more. Just one more. Let's see. Who can give me one? Fatima. Tell me one more activity. And let's finish that round of statements in there.
Check the agenda.
Check the agenda. Ah, okay. Isn't it there? Let's see. Vamos a revisar. Check my email, type the letter, write the report. Ah, okay, good. Yeah, check the agenda. That's really important when I have something like really scheduled, right? Okay, that's great. Uh-huh.
Otra actividad podría ser respond immediately to the email.
No, okay. Okay, respond or answer immediately emails. Okay, very good. That's another one. Okay. So you open it, you check your email, you open a new emails, and then you respond or answer those emails. Okay, immediately. Very good, Roxana. That's another one. Okay, that's pretty much what we can add to that. For tomorrow, I think we're gonna finish this activity. Okay, about this is just a filling blanks. Esto lo vamos a terminar mañana. Okay, before we go, okay, cause let's see, 10:01. Antes de irnos, listen up. I want to tell you something. Listen. ¿Todos tienen acceso a la plataforma? ¿Todos han podido accesar a la plataforma? ¿O hay alguien que todavía no haya podido?
Yo ya pude accesar, teacher, pero no me aparece el curso.
¿Qué le aparece nada más, Carlos?
Fíjese que ingreso donde dice perfil nivel 2 principiante, ¿verdad?
Ajá.
Ahí me manda siempre al curso.
Ok, vaya, permítame. Voy a dejar de compartir para poner la página de la plataforma. Permítame. I'm gonna paste this thing. Okay, I got it in here. Bien. Cuando, okay, cuando googleamos inglés, okay, online, del inglescorporativo.net, aparece acá, la página principal. Okay. Acá le damos en esta opción de ingresar. Let's see, vamos a ver. Okay, in here I got my email and password, and then I say I click iniciar sesión. Y Carlos, ¿le aparece así de inglés principiante módulo 2? ¿Cuándo accede? Así. ¿Carlos?
Hola, teacher.
¿Le aparece así?
Información, no.
¿No le aparece así?
No.
Ah, ok. Sí, porque tendría que aparecerle inglés principiante módulo 2. Acá le tiene que dar clic in here. Y ya le aparece el layout de la plataforma. Acá que tenemos la opción del curso, discusión, progreso, el manual, some notes. Okay. Ok, para los que es primera vez que estamos con el uso de la plataforma, acá en sección 1, solo le damos clic, lo de la sección 1 es semana 1. Okay. Son las tareas que vamos a hacer con relación a la semana 1. Y acá, tenemos el tema de la videoconferencia, okay, videoconferencia 1, Simple Present Statements. Acá, el día de mañana, les va a aparecer el video de esta videoconferencia, ok. Acá, a la par acá, si ven, dice tarea 1. Entonces, le vamos a dar clic acá y ya está la tarea con relación a esta videoconferencia que hemos tenido. Acá lo que vamos a hacer es rellenar. Ok, con la opción que ustedes crean que es la más adecuada para poder completar las oraciones. ¿Sí? Simplemente son 5. Cuando ya la hemos completado, le damos enviar. Ok, si alguna nos sale mal, podemos hacer varias veces esta tarea. Ok, y acá no hay eso de que a lo mejor porque me salieron dos malas, si lo vuelvo a hacer me va a bajar puntos o something like that. No, acá entre más podamos practicar, mejor. Y así es el desarrollo de cada una de ellas. Acá es videoconferencia 2, que sería la de mañana. Igual, ahí estaría la tarea 2. La videoconferencia 3, tarea 3, hasta llegar a la número 5. ¿Ok? Que ya sería la tarea 5, que el mismo viernes, a más tardar a medianoche, tendría que estar hecha, porque yo en ese lapso, medianoche, o cuando mucho, sábado por la mañana, mando sus notas. ¿Okay? Las notas las recolecto de acá y las envío. Es un reporte semanal que se les tiene que estar enviando a Insaport, ¿okay? Para ver cómo va su desarrollo. Carlos, pero cuando coloca su dirección y su correo y contraseña, ¿puede acceder?
Sí, puede accesar. Es que me parece en el primer curso sí no tuve ningún problema, pero si no me voy a apoyar mañana con el personal que tienen ahí en el grupo, ¿verdad? De WhatsApp, para reportarles que no me aparece el curso porque acaba el ingreso, pero no me sale el... específicamente así como la pantallita que usted mostró, ¿verdad?
Ajá, ok.
Entonces, pero quizás me voy a apoyar con ellos mañana y esperaría ya no tener ningún problema para poder comenzar las actividades, ¿verdad?
Vaya, perfecto. Entonces, si tiene algún problema, por favor, escriba al grupo que yo me voy a contactar también con el personal técnico para que les pueda apoyar, ¿ok?
Excelente. Gracias, teacher.
Vaya, perfecto. Entonces, voy a pasar a asistencia.
Teacher, sorry. I have a problem with my profile.
Well,
my last name han dejado solamente un mansor en, y es Herrera un mansor.
Ah, ok. En la parte, permítame. Vamos a ver.
En mi perfil, donde usted tiene su nombre actualmente, Juan Carlos Hernández, a mí me aparece Eric Guillermo Umansor. Es el correcto, Herrera Umansor.
Ah, muy bien. A veces eso simplemente es el usuario, pero voy a revisar acá si lo tengo correcto. Permítame.
Ok, gracias.
Solo vamos a revisar acá.
Sí, porque a mí no me permitió modificarlo. Me decía que tengo, soy limitado.
Ah, perfecto. Ok.
Ah, ahí está Eric Guillermo Umansor.
Ok, un second.
Yeah.
In here.
Yes.
Ok, es Eric Guillermo Umansor. It's like that.
Herrera Umansor.
Herrera Umansor.
Eric Guillermo Herrera Umansor. Uh-huh.
Ah, perfecto. Muy bien, voy a comentar eso entonces. Voy a comentar para ver si pueden hacer la modificación, ¿ok? O si no hay ningún problema, voy a preguntar si no hay ningún inconveniente, ¿ok? Y yo le comento a usted, ¿ok?
Ok, thank you, teacher.
All right, perfect. Voy a dejar de compartir entonces. Paso asistencia para ya dar por finalizada la sesión. Give me a second. All right, we don't have any other question. Let's see. Amilcar Gustavo. All right, perfect. Ana Claribel.
Present.
Nice. Ana María.
Present.
Thank you. Carlos Eduardo.
Present.
All right, Mr. Eric Guillermo.
Present.
Okay, nice. Stephanie Janet.
Present.
Okay, excellent. Fátima Alejandra.
Present, sir.
Okay, thank you. Gilmar Cruz.
Present.
Okay, thank you. Jonathan Alexander. Jonathan, I got problems with the internet. Carla Benazir.
Present.
Okay. Natalie Vanessa.
Present.
Excellent. Nubia Zulema.
Present.
Okay, good. Romeo Alexis.
Present.
Okay, thank you. Rosa del Carmen.
Present.
All right, good. Roxana Yesenia.
Present.
Okay, thank you. Salvador Alfonso.
Present, teacher.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Stephanie Adeline is not here. Stephanie Lizette, not here. William Alberto. Okay, I think he left. All right, and the last one, Joanny Noemi.
Present.
Okay, very good. Now, the first feedback, it's going to be given to, let me see, Stephanie Janet. I want you to stay with me for 10 minutes, okay? Today. Okay, for the rest, muy bien, para los demás, si no tenemos alguna otra duda, alguna otra pregunta, estamos en contacto en el grupo de WhatsApp, cualquier duda, por favor, ahí escriban que ahí vamos a estar pendientes, okay? So, let's see you tomorrow.
Okay.
In another conference. Bye. Bye-bye.
Bye.
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 Bye. Good night.
Bye. Bye. Good night.
Good night.
Bye. Good night, everybody.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.
Teacher, una duda.
Sí, dígame, Romeo.
Fíjese que estaba buscando lo del manual.
Ajá.
Entonces, en el grupo, estaba viendo que a la mayoría lo han eliminado y a mí también.
Romeo, es que creo que es que han creado otro grupo, Romeo.
Ah, bueno, en el link que mandó no me aparece, lo estaba buscando en el chat.
Vaya, en el link solo tiene que darle en el link y el link lo va a poner abrir con WhatsApp. Y luego cuando abre con WhatsApp, ahí dice unirse al grupo.
Es que no me aparece el link en el chat que lo subió, lo estoy buscando y no me aparece.
Ah,
permítame. No sé si lo puede reenviar, por.
Permítame. Ahí está.
Ok. Pues,
ahí está, Romeo. ¿Me confirma si ya le apareció?
Sí, ya logré entrar. Okay,
ok, perfecto, Romeo. Ya le voy a mandar entonces más tarde el PDF con del módulo. Le voy a volver a reenviar para que lo tenga, ¿ok?
Ah, ok, ok.
All right, perfecto, bueno. Romeo. Ok, bye bye. Ok, Mrs. Janet.
Ok, teacher.
You're the first one that is going to receive, right, or take these 10 minutes of feedback. It's 10:13, so we're going to have 10 minutes for discussing if you have any question related to the topic that we have been discussing today. Okay, remember that the topic is simple present. Okay, now I don't know if you have any questions related to the activities that we have been doing.
Bueno, es que en el momento no me genera duda.
Really?
Por ejemplo, el simple present, no tengo duda, ¿verdad? Porque simplemente son oraciones, ¿verdad? Y que las que son en positivo, las puedo hacer en negativo, solo les agrego ahí el, si es en negativo, el don't, ¿verdad? O el doesn't.
Don't, ajá, si es primera persona, don't. Segunda o plural.
Ajá. Y el doesn't.
If it is he.
En tercera persona.
Ajá, he, she, it, o proper names, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Like Stephanie, like Juan, like, okay? Only one okay. Person. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Pues, por ahorita creo que no tengo más.
Not that much?
No.
Okay, how about the rules? Do you remember the rules? For third person?
¿No?
¿Se acuerda de las reglas sobre las terceras personas? ¿Cómo usar los verbos en tercera persona? Do you remember them?
En tercera persona,
ajá.
Este, hay que agregarle la ES, ¿verdad? Uh-huh.
Ok, ¿a qué verbo se le agrega ES? ¿A qué terminaciones?
ES es cuando termina en consonante, ¿verdad? ES.
¿En consonante? Ok. Hay algunas terminaciones, ¿ok? Uh-huh. Son alrededor de 5 o 6 terminaciones de verbos los cuales nosotros podemos agregarle ES, ¿ok? Cuando tienen esas terminaciones. Vaya. Le voy a dar un ejemplo. Por ejemplo, el verbo go termina en O. Entonces, uh-huh. Por eso es que le agregamos ES. Por ejemplo, tenemos el verbo go, tercera persona, goes. Tenemos el verbo do, tercera persona, does.
Does.
Ok. ¿Qué otras terminaciones podemos tener o tenemos para agregar ES en tercera persona?
También este, cuando decimos student, se le agrega S también, ¿verdad?
Yeah, we add the S, uh-huh. Students. Para la mayoría de verbos students. Agregamos S. Ajá.
Sí. Okay. Quiero ver cuál otro. También cuando decimos brushes.
Ok, ¿qué terminación es esa?
Ese.
Ah, ok. Uh-huh. Ok. Y es un verbo cuando, cuando ahí lo usamos cuando el verbo termina en SH. Ok. SH.
Uh-huh.
Entonces, uh-huh. La terminación es para ES. Colocar ES en tercera persona son verbos que terminen en O, verbos que terminen en X. Ok. X. Verbos que terminen en SH. SH, CH, CH, y verbos que terminen en X, right? X, as we
were saying. X.
Ajá, exactly. Uh-huh. Tal es el caso del verbo fix.
Fix, ajá, que se le agrega S. Uh-huh.
Exactly, all right, sí. Exactly. That happens in third person. Ahora bien, había otra regla especial, que era la que usted mencionaba, que vaya, termina en Y el verbo, pero antes de la, cuando va antes de la Y, una vocal simplemente se agrega S. Ese es el caso del verbo play.
Play.
Termina en Y, ok. It ends or finishes in Y, but before Y is a vowel, A. Okay. Antes de la Y tenemos una vocal, que en este caso es A. Entonces, en ese caso, ¿qué hacemos en tercera persona? Simplemente agregamos una S.
S.
Ok, good. Pero, ¿qué sucede con los verbos que terminan en Y, pero antes de la Y va una consonante? Tal es el caso de study o el verbo try. Ok, terminan en Y, pero antes de la Y llevan una consonante. ¿Qué agregamos ahí?
No se le agrega el ING. No, ¿verdad?
No.
La S entonces, nada más.
No. No. A ver, vamos a... Ah, come on, Stephanie.
Sí, una, mamá, es que tenemos... yo en eso sí, me, eso sí en cuanto a esto de los verbos y todo eso sí me confundo un poquito.
Ok, good. Vaya, tenemos el verbo study. Lo acabo de escribir en el chat.
Ah, es ES.
¿ES? No. Sí, le ponemos ES, pero antes de eso hacemos una modificación.
I don't remember.
Ok, no problem. Listen up. Cuando un verbo termina en Y, pero antes de la Y va una consonante, como en el verbo study, lo que hacemos es que eliminamos la Y.
La Y.
Ajá. Y la cambiamos a I de puntito y normal. Uh-huh. ¿Okay? Y agregamos ES. Tenemos study, studies. Ok. Tenemos otro ejemplo del verbo try. Try. ¿Sí ve?
Try.
Termina en Y, pero después, antes de la Y, lleva una consonante. Uh-huh. Entonces.
Tries.
Tries. Very good. Uh-huh. Like this. Look. She tries to finish her work. Yeah, like ella intenta terminar su trabajo. You see, try means intentar, okay? Ese es el significado del verbo try. Okay, very good. Igual vamos a revisar un poco estas reglas el día de mañana. Sí. Mañana vamos a tener un tema un tanto diferente en cuanto al uso de oraciones, porque vamos a agregar algo que se llama time expressions. Expresiones de tiempo, like time expressions. Entonces va a estar bastante interesante la videoconferencia de mañana, like related to this, obviously. So I don't know if you have any extra questions. ¿Todo bien con la plataforma?
Sí, con la plataforma todo bien.
Ok,
sí.
Perfect.
De hecho, hice la primera tarea también en lo que es la plataforma.
Ah, great, that's good. otra cosa que vamos a estar haciendo en la plataforma y se los voy a mandar al grupo directamente. Voy a estar subiendo ahora sí en la parte de discussion, en la parte de discusión. Voy a estar dejando un tema de discusión cada día. Ok, para así cuando hagamos las actividades, cuando hagamos las tareas, igual nos vayamos a la parte de discusión porque siempre va a haber un tema de discusión. Probablemente sea del mismo tema que hemos estado impartiendo la videoconferencia. De ese mismo día voy a dejar un tema en esa parte de discusión para que lo puedan desarrollar. En este caso simplemente es práctica adicional. Por ejemplo, si el tema de ahora fue statements using simple present, entonces probablemente les pida que me hagan un par de oraciones, ya sea de forma afirmativa o forma negativa, Exacto, utilizando tercera persona o utilizando plurales. Okay.
Va, en cuanto al de a la tarea, la primera tarea, sí no va a haber eso.
¿Hola?
En esa primera tarea, sí no va a haber eso de la, esa parte de la discusión, no, no la vamos a hacer.
Sí la vamos a hacer. Okay, la voy a postear ahora, ¿ok?
Ahora.
Desde ahora, sí, ahora. Y vamos a tener el resto del día mañana para poderlo hacer. ¿Vale? Es algo corto, pero la idea es que podamos interactuar. Digamos, tener un poco más de práctica, aparte de la que vamos a tener con la tarea en la plataforma y con la práctica que hacemos acá en clase. ¿Ok? That's what we're gonna do. Okay, entonces cualquier cosa, ahí vamos a estar en el grupo de WhatsApp, ¿ok?
Ok.
Like, perfect. Ok, so thank you, Janet, and have a wonderful night, ok?
Good night.
See you tomorrow.
Bye, bye.
Okay, bye, bye.